The Whole Armor of God, Issue 3. Cheaters Never Prosper.
Written and illustrated by Chevis Davis. Narrated by Chevis Davis, the author. In this world, we exist in two realms, the physical and the spiritual. What happens in our spiritual realm is manifested in our physical world. In life, we will have challenges, we will have struggles, and even our own demons. The only way to overcome our struggles, conquer our challenges, and to destroy our demons by putting on the whole armor of God.
We see spotlights and a sign well lit that says Harlot Haven.
The time is 6:55 a.m., and with most of his money spent, Jethro Johnson attempts to return home, reeking the despondent stench of pride and self-pity. They call it a gentleman's club. This is a place where men that aren't true gentlemen waste their lives, money, and time. Before fixing broken homes, they use Satan's tools to build bridges between their wives and families, always forsaking God's power and his everlasting love.
Hey, honey. You want a dance?
What?
Her eyes, so beautiful, many men lay spiritually slain from her gaze. Her scent is like a peach orchard, a sweet savor, but intoxicating to the sensories. Her lips, more desirable than most men can ever tame themselves to resist. Am I most men?
Well, honey, what can I do for you? Any fantasy, any wish, I can make it come true.
Seducing words that any man would want to hear. Am I any man? Should I succumb to the temptation? I could, and just blame it on the alcohol. If I surrender to her request, she could have all my money and my soul would follow. What would a man give in exchange for his soul? Matthew 16:26. What kind of man am I?
Sorry, sweetie. I need to go home to my wife. Besides, I'm broke.
Well, won't your wife wonder why you're coming home broke on payday?
Her breath is so fresh and her body is so...
reality.
Any man who looks at a woman lustfully has already committed adultery with her in his heart. Matthew 5:28.
I gotta get out of here. What was I thinking? I have a wife, a family. Lord, please forgive me. Can I forgive myself? Good morning, babe.
The lies, the deception.
Baby, that's you? My goodness, babe, you stink. Where have you been?
Yeah, I had a rough morning.
Little did they know that sin sits at the front door. Could anything make this day worse? This day has only just begun.
Well, I'm going to take a shower. Care to join me?
Hello.
Hi. May I speak to Brenda, please?
It's pretty early. She's busy. Can I help you?
No. Just tell her a friend called.
What the...
How soon can the tables turn? Jethro's blood boils, burns like lava, with just the thought of his wife with another man. But what about his own sins?
Babe, did the phone ring? Babe? 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 Who was it, hon?
It was David. Do you want to tell me something?
What lies ahead for a spouse that is caught cheating? Meanwhile, Elijah, relieved that he has overcome yet another spiritual battle. Elijah knows his power resides in his prayer for peace, but the war seems far from over.
Bye. I'm leaving. Mom? Dad? Be merciful unto me, O God, be merciful unto me. I will cry unto God Most High, unto God that performeth all things for me. For my soul trusts in thee, yea, in the shadow of thy wings I will make my refuge, until these calamities be overpassed. He shall send from heaven and save me from the reproach of him that would swallow me up. Selah. God shall send forth his mercy and his truth. My soul is among lions, and I lie even among them that are set on fire, even the sons of men whose teeth are spears and arrows, and their tongue a sharp sword. Be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory be above all the earth. They have prepared a net for my steps. My soul is bowed down. They have digged a pit before me, into the midst whereof they are fallen themselves. Selah. My heart is fixed. O God, my heart is fixed. I will sing and give praise. Awake up, my glory, awake. Psaltery and harp, I myself will wake early. I will praise thee, O Lord, among the people. I will sing unto thee among the nations. For thy mercy is great unto the heavens, and thy truth unto the clouds. Be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory be above all the earth.
As Elijah arrives at school, he finds himself in deep thought and deep prayer due to his family situation.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom,
the power, and
the glory, forever and ever.
Ah!
Man.
My fault. I was kind of lost in my thoughts.
No prob. You dropped your Bible.
Yeah. A soldier can't go to war without a weapon.
Indeed, your sword must be ready.
My name's Elijah, but everybody calls me Eli, or EJ.
Oh, okay. Nice to meet a fellow brother in Christ.
What's your name?
My name is...
Yo, Levi. Do you have your notes for science?
Yeah? Why?
Let me borrow them, so I can cram before fifth period, you know?
No prob. But I need them back by third period, so that I can review them before class.
Alright, man. Good looking out.
Proverbs 18:23-24. A poor person makes supplications, but a rich man answers harshly. A person who has friends may be harmed by them. There is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. Later that day, third period.
Where is Don with my notes?
Sometimes our efforts to help others go unnoticed and unreturned.
Hey, thanks, Levi.
High five.
But God tells us not to be weary in our well-doing. 2 Thessalonians 3:13.
What?
Thanks again, Levi.
Napoleon? He's an F student. How did he get an A?
Hey, Levi, pass that test.
Hey, Levi, got an A on that test, boy.
For sure, Levi.
Hey, pass that test.
An A on that test, boy.
Hey, I'm a star now.
Hey, sir. Levi, you snap, dog.
You smart, bro.
Appreciate that, boy.
Yes, sir.
The series of unknown pupils thanking Levi leaves him perplexed, which furthermore fueled his thesis of discontent.
What is everybody talking about? Something's not right.
Don finally arrives with Levi's notes, and it is now the beginning of fifth period, 3 minutes before the bell rings, and Levi is at his breaking point.
Here, Levi.
Hey, man. I told you I needed them by third period. I don't have time to look over my notes.
Whoa. At least I gave them back. My bad. See you later.
He wanted to say a few choice words to Don. Levi then remembers his commitment. These thoughts follow.
Anger, but sin not.
Put away all your notes and clear your desks.
He struggles to focus on his test. He notices a student holding a small sheet of paper under the desk and another at his arm. Not only did Don give Levi his notes late, but he made cheat sheets for everyone in the class.
Is he cheating? Are those my notes?
Minutes after the test, the teacher passes them back. Mostly everyone gets an A on the test, while A-average Levi gets a D.
Finally, payday. At least something good has come up this day.
Levi looks at his paycheck and notices that he is not paid in full the wage of hours he worked.
Mr. Lee, I think there is a mistake on my check.
How so?
Well, I worked 30 hours last week, but you have only 23 listed.
Oh yeah, I had to take out extra for lunch and breaks.
What?
And you know, times are rough right now. And since you are almost family, I didn't think you would mind.
Well, I'm taking the day off, and this is my last day.
What? But Levi, I need you tonight.
Whatever. I can't believe you cheated me.
On Fridays, Levi and a couple of his friends go downtown to break dance for passersby. They take donations from the audience and split the money at the end of the night.
We got a nice crowd. I know we should pull a lot of cash tonight.
Yeah, man, I'm glad you made it. You're the best breaker we know.
Hosea 12:7. The businessmen love to cheat. They use dishonest scales.
Peace.
All right, y'all.
Where are they going so fast? We had a good night, huh?
Yeah, man. You were awesome tonight. We almost made a grand.
For real?
Yeah, we each took our extra 100 for gas. And since you rode with me, I figured that you would be straight with that. Then we split the rest. So here's your $100.
What? You tripping, man. All that work and this is how you do me? God have mercy on you.
Hey, Levi! You don't want to ride?
I'm straight.
Jeremiah 9:4. Everyone must be on guard around his friends. He must not even trust his own relatives, for every one of them will find some way to cheat him. Psalms 55:1-13. Give ear to my prayer, O God, and hide not yourself from my plea for mercy. Attend to me and answer me. I am restless in my complaint, and I moan. Because of the noise of the enemy, because of the oppression of the wicked, for they drop trouble upon me, and in anger they bear a grudge against me. My heart is in anguish within me.
The terrors of death have fallen upon me, and horror overwhelm me. Psalms 55, 9 through 13. Destroy, O Lord, divide their tongues, for I see violence and strife in the city. Day and night they go around it on the walls, and iniquity and trouble are within it. Ruin is in the midst. Oppression and fraud do not depart from its marketplace. For it is not an enemy who taunts me, then I could bear it. It is not an adversary who deals insolently with me, then I could hide from him. But it is you, a man, my equal, my companion, my familiar friend.
Levi, are you hungry?
I'm good. I'm tired. Going to bed.
I wonder what the matter with him.
He's a teenager. I think that's enough.
Psalms 49, 1 through 5. Hear this, all ye people. Give ear, all ye inhabitants of the world, both low and high, rich and poor, together. My mouth shall speak of wisdom, and the meditation of my heart shall be of understanding. I will incline my ear to a proverb. I will solve my riddle to the music of the harp. Why should I fear in the time of trouble when the iniquities of those who cheat me surround me? Levi looks around and notices fiery eyes surrounds him.
All you have to do is take back what is rightfully yours.
It's dark and it's very hot.
Are you afraid of the dark? Because it's about to get real scary up in here.
What? Malachi 2, verse 1. Woe to those who devise wickedness and work evil on their beds. Within the morning dawns they perform it, because it is in the power of their hand.
What does he know about power? The power is in my hand. The same hand that will destroy you and bring you dead.
Proverbs 11, verse 3. The integrity of the upright guides them, but the crookedness of the treacherous destroys them.
Your stupidity and integrity will always keep you poor in spirit and flesh.
Proverbs 11, verse 4. Riches do not profit in the day of wrath, but righteousness delivers from death.
Look behind you.
What? Where did he go so fast?
Right here. How rude, you ask me to dance without even asking my name. Remember me, boy. I am Cheetah.
His breath was like death and mutual. His jagged claws tore through my clothes and skin, like a key trying to cut through cardboard. The pressure of his weight pressed me like a bad 13-year-old in a ketchup packet, and I'm about to pop. I felt so weak, useless, defeated, until I remembered these words. Ephesians 6, verse 10, 12-17.
Finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
Get off of me!
This is going to be a fight, remember?
Indeed. But you won't even be a memory when I'm finished with you.
Come and get it.
I'm on my way.
Seems that you left out the part about we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers. Against the authorities, against cosmic powers over this present darkness, against spiritual forces of evil in high places. It's talking about me!
Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, having done all to stand firm. Stand, therefore, having fasten the belt of truth.
Superb!
The gates to hell will not prevail.
What fun!
And having put on the breastplate of righteousness. And as for shoes on your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace.
Get thee, head Satan.
On the contrary, I think I'll stay in front, beside, and behind you. Then this fight will be like taking candy from a baby. I'm going to take my time peeling your armor off like a candy wrapper.
In all circumstances, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish the flaming darts of the evil one.
What's the matter? You forgot what your Bible says?
No, I need it.
For what? It won't save you. It's just paper and glue. It will burn up just like you.
And the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God.
Jeremiah 7, verses 8 to 10. Behold, you trust in deceptive words to no avail. Will you steal, murder, commit adultery, swear falsely, and go after other gods that you have not known? Then come and stand before me, in this house which is called by God's name, only to continue doing all these abominations. Well, no more! James 5, verses 5 to 6. You have lived on earth in luxury and in self-indulgence. You have fattened your hearts in a day of slaughter.
I hear you talking, but you ain't saying nothing. Pardon my grammar.
Finish him!
You have condemned and murdered the righteous person. I can now resist you. It is done. What a terrible nightmare.
Morning, honey. You got the call yesterday for position at the art supply store.
What?
Yeah, $10 an hour. I would have told you last night, but you stormed to the room.
Thanks, Mom.
Thank God.
Psalms 37, verses 18 to 25. The Lord knows the days of the blameless, and their heritage will remain forever. They are not put to shame in evil times. In the day of famine, they have abundance. But the wicked will perish. The enemies of the Lord are like the glory of the pastures. They vanish. Like smoke, they vanish away. The wicked borrow, but does not pay back. But the righteous is generous and gives. But those blessed by the Lord shall inherit the land, but those cursed by him shall be cut off. The steps of a man are established by the Lord, when he delights in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be cast headlong, for the Lord upholds his hand. I have been young and now am old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his children begging for bread.
Hi, this is Chivas Davis, the creator of the Whole Armor comic book series. We thank all the amazing voice talents that made these books come to life. We hope that you enjoy this book and will continue as we journey throughout the series. I intended for these books to be a creative manna so that you can have bread for your journey. Find out more about the Whole Armor comic book series at thewholearmorcomicbook.com and order a hard copy today. Like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube page and follow us on Facebook and Instagram at The Whole Armor Comic Book. Be blessed and Godspeed.